This is Ratcliffe-on-Soar Power Station. Opened in 1968, this is one of the last coal-fired power stations in Great Britain. If you head into Nottingham on the A453, you really can't miss it, dominating the landscape with its 8 huge concrete cooling towers. It was supposed to have been closed down by now, but it's still running thanks to the ongoing energy crisis. It's now scheduled to close in 2024, when the government plans to end coal-fired power generation completely. It has a large stockpile of coal. According to Uniper, the operator, it runs on hard coal, anthracite. As coal goes, it's the highest grade and cleanest burning. The coal is delivered by merry-go-round hopper train, which moves continuously as each wagon dumps its load of coal through the bottom. Conveyors take the coal to the stockpiles, or from there to be pulverised before burning in one of the 4 boilers. Each boiler, through its own steam turbine and generator, outputs 500 megawatts. There's also 70 megawatts of gas turbines for emergencies, in the small brown building at the front with its own chimney. The total capacity is 2 gigawatts. This is usually stated as being enough for 2 million homes, which assumes a kilowatt each. It's roughly 4% of total generation in Britain. When making this video, the power station was running to deal with an electricity shortage. At this moment, new load shedding schemes are also being used for the first time. Britain has built much renewable energy generation in recent years, but on cold, windless winter nights, grid capacity is very tight. The cooling towers disperse waste heat as water vapour. There's no combustion gases here, only from the chimney. The gases are treated with flue gas desulfurisation and selective catalytic reduction processes that still contain up to 10 million tonnes of CO2 annually. Next to the power station is East Midlands Parkway railway station, with trains as far south as London or north as Sheffield. The trains run on diesel, not electricity. The electricity from the generators goes to a large building full of switchgear and transformers before heading out on the national grid at 275 and 400 kilovolts, as well as regional distribution lines at 132 kilovolts. These are national grid lines. One of the circuits is 275 kV, the others are 400 kV. These head to large national grid substations, many of which used to serve their own coal-fired power stations like this one. According to National Grid, lines like these can carry a maximum of 1.8 gigawatts per circuit, that's one set of 3 phases on each side of the pylon. So in theory, almost the entire output of this power station can be carried by half of one of these pylons. That was Ratcliffe-on-Soar Power Station, thank you for watching. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please do one or all of the 3 things literally every YouTube channel asks you to. Someone commented on my first video, and then I made this, the second. Will there be a third? Subscribe to find out.